Hi there and welcome to Inktober Day 14. Today's prompt is empty, and first I just want to apologise in case my voice is a little bit croaky. I think it's a bit croaky. I have a bit of a sore throat coming on, so I'm just really hoping that I'm not going to get ill, because obviously I really want to get Inktober finished and I want to be able to complete the entire challenge, so I just really hope that I don't get ill, because voiceovers are going to be really hard if I do get ill. But anyway, today's prompt is empty, and for this one I did go a little bit kind of dark. I don't know what it is about using India ink, it just kind of makes me want to do, it's hard to do like really happy, pretty pastel pink things. Like, I don't know what it is, something about using black India ink just makes me kind of want to do darker art. It's really strange. I've never really done anything like this, so this is very experimental, just all of this Inktober so far, really, because I tend to use pastel colours and pinks and bright colours, and really not being able to do that has altered the kind of art that I'm creating, which is really interesting. I feel like if I'd have done this in watercolour, or like a limited palette watercolour, but the entire Inktober, the same prompts, I think I would have done completely different things. If I could have done empty using like pinks and purples, I probably would have just done like an empty basket or something, but instead my head went to the portrait of a person that's basically crying, really sad and just not happy about life, kind of being strangled by a skeleton. That's kind of where my head went, because I'm using black India ink. It's not going to be as dark as that sounds, but that's basically the gist of it. It's a portrait of a person not doing great, and it's not necessarily been strangled, it's just more representative, I think, of just kind of being held in the throat by skeleton hand. You know, I feel like I can't really put to words exactly what I'm trying to portray here. I'm not really great with words, but that's the gist that I'm going for. You can kind of understand the meaning behind it, I think. So yeah, I'm kind of happy with how this piece went. However, there wasn't a clear portrayal that I was going to do. I also had issues when I did the India ink, like this dip line work here, because I really struggled to not dip my hand in it, and I tried to work left to right because that's kind of where I've been going wrong. As you can see, I basically did dip my hand in it, but I tried to work left to right to try and avoid that, but I do have certain areas where my hand just went in it and I'm so annoyed by that. But yeah, at the beginning, I think I did go right to left. I just completely forgot that I was right-handed and I dunked my hand in it quite a lot. But this time I didn't do it so much, but I still did. And that's kind of annoying, because the bit that I dunked my hand in was supposed to be the bone, which is obviously going to be really quite light. So that didn't exactly go great. But yeah, for this one, I lit a candle again, and I really love the kind of chill vibes. I'm not exactly looking forward to winter, because I'm a summer gal. I love the summer, the warmth, and I don't like the cold in the slightest, but there was something kind of cozy about putting a candle on, and I did like it, so I think I might do that a little bit more in future. It was actually really kind of relaxing just looking at a candle as I was going. I really liked it. My nose doesn't really work much though, so I can't really smell it too much, but I like it, it's kind of relaxing. So basically, I think the entire background was supposed to be white, and I end up colouring, or I mean not colouring, but like adding ink to a lot of the backgrounds that I've done so far. The reason for that is I splashed the ink a lot, and it's not going to be a really nice clean white background if I've got splashes all over it that aren't intentional. So that's why I kind of added this vibe. I originally went in with just the really light grey, and I just felt like there wasn't enough contrast because the skin was a very similar colour and the bone was obviously very light. It just didn't really go. So then I added some lines, and the kind of vibe that I was going for here is sort of like a prison, if you know what I mean. I feel like that's kind of what I'm trying to portray. I don't think I've exactly executed this one very well, but I think, you know, you kind of can get the vibe of where I was going with it. I just kind of combined several things. But the background was obviously made on the spot. And then I had to make the dark, the dark parts actually pop a lot more. So the eyebrows had to be made darker, the hair had to be made darker. The hair is very one-dimensional, I must admit. I don't have much experience with hair and I really do want to practice with that. But yeah, I had to make a lot of areas darker. Even the bone I had to make darker in the end because it's just very low contrast, this one. I think that's been a very common theme here with this India ink. The way that I probably should have handled this was to change the skin tone to a slightly darker skin tone, but because I'd already done one layer, I kind of thought, if I add more, I'm probably just going to ruin it. I was somewhat happy with the face, and I don't really have enough experience with India ink to wet it and just kind of hope for the best again. It's kind of a difficult medium to control, that's kind of what I've been noticing, so I just did not want to risk it, so I just darkened the hair, the eyebrows, and a bit of the bone really. I finally just grabbed a white gel pen after adding the actual kind of like prompt in that on the bottom, and I wanted to add a highlight to the eyes, and then the tears kind of got lost, so I actually added white in the tears. I probably could have done like masking fluid and left it, but my masking fluid was off and I haven't replaced it yet, so I just put some white in the middle for the tears, and I probably shouldn't have filled them in entirely because that didn't really work. But I do think the white highlight kind of helped. And this is how the final piece looked. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this one. Make sure you're following for tomorrow's for day 15. Bye bye.